it's Faye. What's up, guys? So, I actually had already made this video, but, it was too long for me to upload mobily. So, unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to actually show you guys me grinding through the levels because it's going to be too long. But, this is the video that I was telling you guys I was going to upload. I'm going to be showing you guys, a leveling guide for 15 to 50, and then what quests and what to do once you get to 50, and from there you'll do that quest to 70. All right, so let's get started here because I don't want to waste a lot of time since I have to keep the videos under 15 minutes. If you're one of those players that you like to grind, you like to level, you like to actually play the game. And you plan on, you know, going to grind right after you get out of the tutorial, I'm going to show you where to go from here. Because this is where you'll come out after you finish the tutorial. Now, I know most of you are going to be super lazy and just go get boosted. Some of you, like, get boosted to, like, 70, 80. Some of you are really, really lazy and even go for, like, 100, 120. But, this is for the people who actually like to play the game, the way it was intended to be played. So, yeah, I'm going to show you guys where to go. Now, I've already leveled, obviously, because, like I said, I had already made the video, and I had grinded my way to 50, but the video was too long. I didn't know that there was a upload limit if you uploaded mobily. Or whatever. There's like a 15 minute limit. So I wasn't able to use it, unfortunately. I guess maybe I was thinking things will be different. But I'm just gonna be able to show you guys where to go and what quests to take and whatnot. I will be running everywhere the first time around. After that, I'm just going to use Tellies for everything. This is just to show you guys where to go if you're a new player, like a really new player, and you actually don't even know where to go. So make sure you pay attention. Children, how was school? It was good. How about you? I love you. I love mama too. Are you ready for dinner? I'm able to set the table till I snap out the fable when that TV turn off and I realize I'm back in hell. I love coming to Rococo during the events, especially Halloween. I don't know about you guys, but Halloween is my favorite holiday. And I definitely think they go all out for Halloween compared to, like, the other events. Christmas is another one that they decorate big time for, but I think even Halloween has a little more decorations up than what the Christmas event does. It looks so cool. Oh, speaking of this event, if you're new and it's your first time playing and your first time doing the Halloween event, if you come over here to GM Nights, you can actually pick up tickets for experience, drop, or production. I'm going to do experience since this is a leveling guide and I got to level this little nubby. Okay, so now you're on the map, and you're gonna be at this map for a while. Okay, what you're gonna wanna do is you see these trees over here? They're called bombs. You're gonna kill these, and they're gonna drop a collectible called Broken Staff. You see that at the bottom? There's a quest that you take in Capital City Sophia at level 30 called Impromptu Arrows. And if you turn in 30 of these broken arrows, you'll get experience and you'll get spinna for it. Now, me personally, I would just I leveled out to 50, and then I went and just turned in all my broken staves. Like, if you want to do so many at a time and then go turn them in, you can. But I think it's a lot easier if you just come here and you grind to 50 and then go turn everything in and collect the levels and stuff from it. So now I'm going to show you guys where to take that quest at. Now, like I said, you can take that quest at level 30, but there's another quest that you can take at level 50 that also drops these broken staves, except the mobs are a little higher leveled. They're level 50, and they also drop, like I said, the broken staves or whatever. Oh my god, back in the day, like when I first started playing this game, these fish right here, they drop piney wings or peeny wings, I'm not sure how you pronounce them. But if you had those, you were the shit. Ah, oh, those were the days. Yeah, it's a little bit of a run, which is another reason why I said it's better just to wait until you hit level 50 and then go turn them in, because I don't think somebody wants to keep running from Sophia back to Coco Plains just to turn in a quest. I mean, unless you're saving up like stacks at a time, but now that Iruna has the experience bonus added into the game, you're gonna level a lot quicker. Like, it took me all but maybe a half an hour to level from 15 to 30. And then another like half an hour, 45 minutes to get from 30 to 50. Okay, so I'm gonna show you, since we're in Capital City Sophia, I'm gonna show you where to take the quest at once you're level 50, and then I'll show you where to take Impromptive Arrows at. Okay, so you come in the pub here, and you come over to this guy in the back. He's a merchant. Click on Quest and Merchant's Misery. Okay, now you come in here, and as you can see, you'll have to kill 30 Daedrons. I'll show you where they are at. The Impromptive Arrows quest is actually in the consulate. It's in the side room. So, like I said, grind bombs until level 50. That's your best bet. If you want to turn in the quest in between once you hit level 30, you can do Impromptive Arrows. But the Daedron quest, that is not until level 50. So, Impromptives, you can start at 30, but I would just wait until you're 50 to turn in all your B staffs. Now, I actually have some B staffs on me to turn in to show as an example. I believe I have like 30. I collected just the amount that you need. Okay, so over here you talk to her, quest, Impromptive Arrows, take the quest. Now, it is going to be a pain to turn this in. It'll take a while, it's really tedious. As you can see, you get 1,000 spinna. And you'll get 7,500 experience. Now I'm going to show you... Oh, I forgot to take the quest again. I'm going to show you guys where the Daedrons are that also drop the broken staffs. Because once you get to level 50, you can still do the Impromptive Arrows quest. But you can also take the Daedron quest. Which is pretty quick. Like, you'll have to run back a lot once you start taking the Daedron quest, but it's not that bad. If you have escape, or if you use teles, or if you just die, you know, it's not too bad. Also, If you have a pet, I would suggest using it so you can pick up even more broken staves. If you're new and you can't, I would suggest actually like buying a pet set from like the stalls or from Rococo or something, just so you have one to use. Also, depending on how geared you are, you may want to have a pet anyways, because these, if you're not really geared or you don't have a lot of HP, these guys can actually hurt you. Right? These are Daedrons, and you're going to kill 30 of these. And like I said, these also drop broken staff. They're every time drop. So you'll get this pretty quick. And once you have 30 of these, you'll go turn in the quest, and then you'll be done. And then you come back and you do the quest again. And you're going to want to do this, the Impromptu Arrows and the Merchant's Misery quest, until level 70. All right, well, I'm going to grind now. I'll be back once I'm level 70, and I'm going to show you guys where to go from there, what quest to take then. I hope this video helped you guys a lot. And as always, thanks for watching, guys. Bye.